Good morning. It's Thursday, December 27, 2018. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, What About Him? And our scripture is John chapter 21. Let's read together. A third time he asked him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt that Jesus asked the question a third time. He said, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. And Jesus said, then feed my sheep. I tell you the truth, when you were young, you were able to do as you liked. You dressed yourself, went wherever you wanted to go. But when you are old, you will stretch out your hands and others will dress you and take you where you don't want to go. Jesus said this to let him know by what kind of death he would glorify God. Then Jesus told him, follow me. Peter turned around and saw behind them the disciple Jesus loved, the one who had leaned over to Jesus during supper and asked, Lord, who will betray you? Peter asked Jesus, what about him, Lord? And Jesus replied, if I want him to remain alive until I return, what is that to you? As for you, follow me. If you're following Jesus as his disciple, there's a lot of questions that are valid and welcome. You can ask, for instance, where do you want me to go? You can ask God, what do you want me to do? You can ask when and even why. Those are all on the table. These are all questions that help give us direction and understanding to the scope and the urgency of Christ's mission. The one question you want to avoid is something that smacks of idle curiosity about someone else's service. Perhaps Peter just couldn't help it. His natural curiosity wanted to probe deeper and know what was in store for John. It doesn't mean Peter wasn't sold on Jesus being the Messiah, Son of God. That much isn't in question. It's just that who can resist the impulse to question if someone else is getting a better deal than you? Peter wanted to probe the possibilities while that conversation was still on the table. Jesus told him to mind his own business and do what Jesus had set out for him, not John. It's like that with us humans. Even when we have a clear view of what God wants us to do, we can't help questioning if there's something better, easier, higher paying, more gratifying, more upper level kind of thing for us. We want what we want. Peter became the chief preacher among the disciples, and I can tell you from experience that a preacher that spends his days dreaming of having a bigger church with a much more prominent pulpit than he or she currently serves is one of Satan's most successful tools for tearing churches apart. When someone who's supposed to be a shepherd caring for the sheep takes his eye off the ball of being a shepherd and wants to climb mountains of fame and prestige, the church is in for a nosedive, and the shepherd is going to wind up in the woodshed. Jesus said, mind the business I gave you. Don't worry about what I want your neighbor to do. For you today. So now that I've bared the soul trouble of status-seeking preachers and probably alienated any of my fellow pastors who read this, how is it going in the pride and social climbing department for you? We're still a few days away from the deadline of writing those resolutions for the new year. You could add a little holy contentment to your list. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.